I am plea bargaining. Your doctor's dirty.
There's nothing linking.
He prescribed Ben Bowers oxycodone, and Ben Bowers died of an oxycodone overdose. That's a link.
And you have a task force looking into pill pushers at local gyms, one of which...
Is Peter holding up okay?
Peter?
Yes. How is he?
He's fine. We have an associate looking into one of these pill pushers at Ben's exact gym.
I can do 1 year in jail, suspended medical license.
No.
I'm sorry.
1 year probation, no jail time. Dr. Wesley prescribed 10 milligram pills for Ben. And the pharmacy may have dispensed incorrectly.
May have. Really, are we playing mayhaves?
Check with the pharmacy. They didn't barcode the transaction. For all we know, they gave him 80 milligram pills by mistake. That's reasonable doubt. Go ahead, give them a call. I'll wait.
You asked me to follow up on the information.
As part of Dr. Wesley's case, not to launch a new one against the pharmacy.
I felt it was my professional duty to follow through. By the way, the pharmacy may not have barcoded Ben's prescription, but they also didn't have 80 milligram oxy in stock that day. You just lost reasonable doubt.
If we could get his jail time down to 4 months instead of a year.
That was yesterday's deal. It's 4 years now, and a revoked medical license.
Hebristophiliac. Women who are irresistibly attracted to dangerous men. It's quite common. Women who propose to Charlie Manson or send their panties to Jeffrey Dahmer.
45 years.
No. See you in court.
Fine. This isn't gangbanger number 5, Miss Lockhart. This is Colin Sweeney. People want him behind bars.
Then people should find better evidence because this screams self-defense, ma'am.
The thing is, these letters didn't just go one way. How's Peter doing?
Fine, thank you.
Where'd you get these?
The victim's house. You see, Mr. Sweeney wrote back, encouraging her, taunting her. I'm sure you can find a psychological term for that, too.
Hysterical prosecution?
45 years. Here is a copy of the victim's diary with some very interesting entries on your client and some quite specific descriptions of their sexual practices. You seem to be down one partner today.
I'm wearing a different tie. What's that matter? We want involuntary manslaughter, 5 years.
With 4 day time off, that's 3 years for a brutal sexual homicide. Second degree, 15 years, and we're putting a 24-hour clock on it. Offer expires tomorrow.
We have proof that Sweeney was stalked. Can we at least stipulate the victim stalked him?
Agreed he was stalked, so?
There are stalker statutes on the books. Statutes that my husband instituted when he was in office.
And your point, Mrs. Florick?
Talk to your boss. What sort of message would he be sending to stalking victims if Sweeney's prosecuted?
Are you really trying to blame the victim defense with Colin Sweeney?
Offer him 10 years and we don't have to go to trial.
And let me talk to my boss.